Hi and welcome. This is Jim Pewter.
It's our holiday weekend sound, and I've got a special guest who's going to bring back a lot of great memories. Her name is Darlene Love. Darlene sang lead with the Crystals, and she sang with Bobby Sox and the Blue Jeans. She had her own group, the Blossoms, and all the records you're going to hear this week, you'll hear the voice of Darlene Love. Here's one of her best from 1963.
Darlene Love singing lead with the Crystals. That's to do, run, run, and she's my guest. Welcome.
Thank you.
A lot of people weren't aware that you were singing on that record because your name's not on the record.
Right.
Yeah. Tell me about yourself, Darlene, how you got started, and first of all, where are you from originally?
Los Angeles, California. Born, raised, except for 5 years.
Then where did you go?
I went to San Antonio, Texas. Uh-huh. My father was a minister. And they moved my church organization moved him there for 5 years to take over a church. Mm-hmm. And I lived there for 5 years, and then I came back to California.
It's great that you're sitting here with us because we're going to be reminiscing all week on our holiday Christmas session and sound. I'm going to ask you about singing and how you got started with, I think your first group was the Blossoms, is that right?
Right.
And you were doing background work, right?
I met the Blossoms while I was in high school. And they were looking for a replacement for one of the girls who was in the group, and I auditioned for the group, and I got in the group.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. One of the first songs you sang on was a great tune called For Your Love by Ed Townsend. Came out in 1958, and I remember seeing Ed sing this song on an Alan Freed Big Beat show when they were touring throughout the Midwest. And how did you meet Ed Townsend around this time?
Well, we had a manager in Hollywood. His name was Eddie Bill, and Eddie and Ed Townsend's manager, they were all located in the same building, along with Renee Hall, and we used to go up to the office about 3 or 4 times a week to rehearse with our manager, because he was also a piano player, and Ed was down the hall, and he would come in and play us all his songs all the time. We got to really be good friends, because we used to laugh at him, oh, you're never going to be successful, you know, kind of funny thing, and he said, I'm going to have a hit, and it's called For Your Love, and we went to do the background with about, oh, I guess 3 or 4 more other people, and it was really great.
For your love, oh, I would do anything. I would do anything for or your kiss. Oh, I would go anywhere. I would go anywhere for your kiss. More foolish I grow with each heartbeat. We all get foolish. That's why I repeat, for your love. Oh, I would do anything. I would do it.
Beautiful song from Ed Townsend. That's Darlene Love singing background with the Blossoms. She's my special guest. And coming up, a song that Duane Eddy recorded in the early 60s. And the Blossoms were also featured with Duane. We'll hear that in just a few seconds. There are many ways of celebrating Christmas, yet wherever you go around the world, the basic spirit remains the same. One of the most popular customs is that of decorating the home during the holiday season. The main attraction in many countries is the Christmas tree, a German contribution. The holly wreath on the front door is an American idea, as is the use of the poinsettia as a traditional Christmas flower. And we have the English to thank for one of our most enjoyable customs, a custom associated with a certain plant, scientifically labeled Viscum album, better known as mistletoe. Each country has its own Christmas traditions. By understanding and sharing these customs, we share something much deeper, an experience of the heart. For the true meaning of Christmas is the same in any language, an eternal message of hope and the wish for peace on earth. And that's the season that we're channeled in right now with Darlene Love. And did you get a chance to get all your Christmas shopping done yet?
Sort of. Yeah. I guess you could say I like the mad rush, so you shop along with everybody else.
I kind of wait till sometime, even Christmas Eve, you know.
Well, I've never been caught. I think one time I got caught on Christmas Eve. Mm-hmm. I try to get it done before that date.
It gets a little hectic. Darlene Love is my guest, and she sang background on so many hit records that you'll be hearing throughout the week, and we'll be featuring her hits as well. And then that great album that she cut with Phil Spector, the Christmas album, will also be forthcoming. You did some work with Lee Hazelwood, a producer who launched the career of Duane Eddy. And there was a song called Dance with the Guitar Man that people probably listening have in their collection and may not be aware that you were on that record. And how did your involvement with Duane Eddy and Lee Hazelwood come about?
Well, I guess you could say the same way most of our sessions, you know, word of mouth gets around. This is the group to use. They're really good. And from doing sessions, we met him because we were doing a lot of work at RCA Victor at the time. And when they don't know who to call, they ask somebody else. And we got to know Lee Hazelwood very well.
Mm-hmm. This was sort of a new concept for Duane because before this time he was doing strictly instrumental with no background. Rebel Rouser had some shouts and whatever, but this was sort of a unique record for him at the time and brought him back on the charts as well.
I think they were trying to figure out something different. Round about that time, people had started using background, and I guess this was Lee's way of producing a girls group along with Dwayne.
Yeah. The twang of Dwayne Eddy and the Rebels along with Darlene Love and the Blossoms. This is Dance with the Guitar Man. Dance with the Guitar Man, Dwayne Eddy, along with the Rebels and Darlene Love and the Blossoms. She's my guest. You're kind of laughing when you're hearing that, huh?
It's been years.
I know. Well, that was 1962. The time goes by so fast, and maybe it doesn't sometimes, but when you listen back to something like that, maybe it seems like just a couple of years ago, doesn't it?
It does. It doesn't seem like it has really been that long ago.
I wanted to ask you about a man that produced so many of your hit records and kind of paved the way for your success in the early 60s, Phil Spector. And Phil, of course, people know him from producing the Righteous Brothers and the Crystals and yourself and the Ronettes and Ike and Tina Turner. And there was a group called Bobby Sox and the Blue Jeans, and you were also in that group. And tell me first about Phil Spector and how you met him.
We were doing sessions at the time, recording sessions, and we were doing a lot of work for a gentleman named Lester Sill, and he knew Phil, and Phil wanted a group to do a record for him right away, and Lester talked to us about it, and we said, oh sure, we'll go and do it. Mainly we thought as just a background, you know, session, but of course when we got there, Phil was there, and he introduced us to Phil, and he wanted me to do the lead on this particular record.
Mm-hmm. This was called Zippity Doodah, and mm-hmm. It was from a Disney movie many years ago. No one had it ever done with this kind of arrangement before. And Phil Spector used to hire some of the best studio musicians in Hollywood, people that have gone on to kind of fame in their own right, Glenn Campbell and
right.
Leon Russell and Hal Blaine, the drummer, so many more. And there was a fellow called Bobby Sheen that sang
right.
with
mm-hmm.
you on this.
Right.
Did you think this was going to be a chart record when he told you that we're going to do Zippity Doodah and you were looking at the music?
No. The first thing I'm sure everybody thinks about is the movie. What was it? Something about
Song of the South.
Song of the South and children's, right? Zippity Doodah. And we said, sure, this man is crazy, Zippity Doodah. Who's going to buy this?
A lot of people did. Bobby Sox and the Blue Jeans with Darlene Love.
this back
feeling during the holiday season with Darlene Love, and this is Jim Pewter. That was Zippity Doodah from 1962. Who came up with the name Bobby Socks and the Blue Jeans?
Phil did. Bobby's name, Bobby Sheen, is his real name is Bobby.
Uh-huh.
And I guess he took the S from his last name, which was Sheen, and we were the Socks.
Socks. Did you do some appearances off of this record?
The first time we left town to go on tour, it was with Bobby Socks and the Blue Jeans for about a year.
Mm-hmm.
The first year that came out, it was so big, we went out on the road with it.
We have a record here called Winter Wonderland. It's a standard holiday song that's been on the scene for a long time. And it was around this time that Phil Spector produced a classic album. It was all Christmas material done up with his arrangements. Jack Nietzsche helped, of course, too. And this was kind of unique, I imagine, for you, going to a session like this and having traditional Christmas songs rearranged this way.
You know, it was the first time Phil had ever let me select the songs I wanted to sing. I did, when he got ready to record this album, he let me choose all the songs I wanted to sing first, and maybe that's why so many of mine on the album.
Yeah, and you picked this one here, Winter Wonderland. Yeah, it's really holds up well, and we've played it down through the holiday seasons in the past. This is our special guest. Here's Darlene Love.
Thank you.
That's Darlene Love singing Winter Wonderland. Just want to give you an update on what's going to be happening all week long during our Christmas week. You'll be hearing songs like Wait Till My Bobby Gets Home Tomorrow. We'll have He's Sure the Boy I Love with Darlene and the Crystals. Darlene's going to sing White Christmas. And then we'll talk about the Righteous Brothers tomorrow, because Darlene Love sang background on just about all their hits. And you'll hear their greatest hit, You've Lost That Lovin' Feelin'. We'll even have a surf rock record on. I bet you didn't know Darlene sang on that one either. King of the Surf Guitar with Dick Dale. And we'll continue on down through the week. And we'll have songs by Sam Cooke and Al Casey and The Honeycomb and so many more with Darlene Love. It's almost like we're having the Crystals on, Bobby Sox and the Blue Jeans, the Blossoms, all in one week. And one person is here because she sang on all those records. I have something to pass along to our people, and then we'll get back with a record that kind of broke with your name on it, finally.
Yeah. Finally.
During the winter months of cold and darkness, the Christmas season comes as a time of light and warmth. The lighted candle is a fitting symbol of this, glowing in the windows of countless homes around the world. For centuries, candles have played a basic part in Christmas celebrations. They light the altars of churches and shine from the branches of millions of Christmas trees. The traditional Christmas candle, large enough to burn continuously throughout the holiday, is still found in many homes, especially in Ireland and parts of England. And the custom of singing carols by candlelight is observed in lands from Denmark to Australia. As we share the Christmas traditions of others, we share in our hearts the spirit of Christmas, the spirit of hope and joy, and of mankind's most earnest wish, the wish for peace and goodwill among the people and nations of the earth. And we're bringing back great memories here with Darlene Love. 1963, you were doing so much work with Phil Spector at the Gold Star Studios in Hollywood. And finally, Phil put your name on a record and decided to launch you as a single artist. And the song was, well, there was a couple of others you did around this time, but this became, I think, your first hit, wasn't it?
Right, it was. It was the first one.
Today I Met the Boy I'm Gonna Marry.
Right.
Did you do television and concert appearances off of this record as yourself?
For about a year and a half.
Uh-huh.
And then I came back home and continued doing what I was doing, background work.
Again, yeah. I imagine you did the Dick Clark show.
Yes, that was a thrill. You know, years ago when that show first came on, you say, oh, if I could just ever get on that show. And when I did finally get on it, I went on it as Darlene Love, not as the Crystals or Bobby Sox and the Blue Jeans. So it was really nice.
Yeah, because, you know, both of us have grown up with American Bandstand.
And, right.
And when you appeared on Dick's show, was he doing it out of Philadelphia at the time?
He was still doing it out of Philadelphia, which really made it great. He hadn't made the move yet.
I see. I wanted to ask you about that show. When an artist went on there, did they play the music real loud when you lip-synced?
Loud. It was as if you were actually, you know, doing it live with a band. Mm. That's the way it sounded, because it was speakers everywhere.
Because that can be a difficult situation if you have to lip-sync, but the music is real subdued.
Right.
You don't get the feeling of it.
You have to go, you have to take your record, really and truly, and listen to it days and days and days to make sure you get the words exactly right when they're playing.
Uh-huh. You want to do it again?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Darlene Love. Yeah, yeah, we gotta move out. Darlene, you're gonna come back tomorrow.
Oh, yes.
You wanna go with me? I gotta pick up a few gifts.
And I'd love to.
Because you wanna get your shot, we might as well do it together.
Right.
Okay. Darlene Love and Jim Pewter, we'll see you tomorrow. Keep it straight ahead. Bye bye.
Darlene Love, 2298 Tuesday.
Welcome, this is Jim Pewter, along with Darlene Love, and are you all ready?
Almost.
Almost? Okay, we're going to kick things off in our holiday session and sound all week long, and open with one of your hits from 1963, Wait Till My Bobby Gets Home.
Yeah.
That's Darlene Love. The memory from our past. Wait till Bobby gets home. Around the Christmas season, do you go to a lot of parties, Darlene, or do you just kind of stay at home?
Mostly you stay at home, but then you have the parties that you do go to, and mostly your friends, and it's especially entertainers. They're home usually that time of the year, a lot of them. So they give a lot of parties during that time, and that's, you'd be jumping from house to house.
Yeah. You just hope that the homes are kind of close. You know? Don't want to get on any freeways or what do they call it back east? I'll think of it in a minute anyway. It's great to have you on the show because of your past connection with the Crystals and Bobby Sox and the Blue Jeans and your own hits. And coming up, we're going to be talking about the Righteous Brothers just a bit later on. Next, I have a tune that was a hit around the Christmas season of 1962. The song was called He's Sure the Boy I Love, and it had on the label The Crystals. And I think to the people listening, if they heard our show yesterday, were never aware that you sang on Do-Do Ron Ron and He's a Rebel, and the next one we're going to play. When you were called upon by Phil Spector for a recording session, would he tell you beforehand what songs you were going to go over? Would he send over like a musical sheet to you with the changes on it and everything?
We would meet at Jack Nitzsche's house. He had a house right in Hollywood that was really centrally located. And we'd go up there, and he would teach me the songs. And I said, well, who is this one is going to be for? Bobby Sox and the Blue Jeans, The Crystals? Mm-hmm. And he would decide who it would be for.
Now, The Crystals were already established out of New York with a couple of records, and then when Phil came back to the West Coast, was there a reason why he used your voice on many of their hits rather than the original group?
During that time, I think they had a falling out, and I guess they were going to go to another label, and which they couldn't at that time, but I guess they thought they could. Mm-hmm. And he owned the name, so he could really record anybody he wanted to record under that name, and it didn't matter.
This is one of your best. Darlene singing lead with The Crystals. He's Sure the Boy I Love.
Always dreamed the boy I love would come along, and he'd be tall and handsome, rich and strong. Now that boy I love has come to me, but he sure ain't the way I thought he'd be.
You're the Boy I Love, Darlene Love and the Crystals, along with Jim Pewter, during the Christmas season of 62. That was a hit record. There are many ways of celebrating Christmas, yet wherever you go around the world, the basic spirit is always the same. As twilight falls on Christmas Eve, the church bells ring out in Norwegian villages and all work ceases. In Italy, it's supper time, and the children slip Christmas letters under their parents' plates. Meanwhile, German children gather around the closed door of the Christmas room, waiting for the doors to open to reveal the holiday magic of lighted tree or nativity scene. In Switzerland, the star singers are abroad, their leader bearing a large white star lit by a candle within. And in the little towns of France, the people walk quietly to church through the falling snow. Whatever the country, whatever the local customs, the true meaning of Christmas is always the same, a time of joy, of hope, and the wish for peace on earth. Around this time of the year, I kind of flash back to my childhood. I imagine you do too, Darlene.
I think everybody does.
Can you remember a special Christmas where everyone was together and maybe you received something special, or did anything comes to mind?
It really does. It was five of us. I have three brothers and a sister, and so that made a total of seven people in one family. And so back in those days, you didn't really get a whole lot. So there was like one special gift. If our parents could afford it, everybody would get it Christmas time. And this is when we were living in San Antonio, Texas. And I got a bicycle for Christmas, so it was really something. It's not like today you buy your children 50 gifts,
I know,
and they play with maybe two of them. Yeah. We got one, and we really appreciated
it. That's right. And then there's a love of family, and
right,
that's so important. Mm. There's some kids today who will get so many gifts, they start opening them up, and then by the time they get to the other gifts, some of the ones they opened beforehand have already broken, you know,
right,
and they're going through tons of packages and papers. We're going to bring back a memory that was a major hit for Bing Crosby in the 40s. And when you did the Phil Spector Christmas album, you mentioned, I believe yesterday, you picked out some of the tunes you wanted to do.
Right. That was my one and only chance to have a say on what I wanted to record.
And this is White Christmas with our special guest, Darlene Love. Darlene Love, I like your little narrative in there. I think that was from the opening of the tune, which Bing Crosby never sang. And
right.
I like that. In fact, when Irving Berlin wrote that tune, he was sitting, I believe, in Beverly Hills by a swimming pool, and he was asked to write it for a movie. And it was around the summertime, you know, to write White Christmas, and that he kind of reflected on that. And
that's the way you think, too, in California, because there's no snow.
That's right. See, I grew up in Minnesota, and we had the snow, and then you come to the West Coast, and it takes a while to get used to. I don't think you ever do, really.
I don't think so. Not if you're from back east.
No. Yeah. White Christmas with Darlene Love. Next, I'm going to talk... well, we both are, about your involvement with the Righteous Brothers, one of the best groups to come out of the West Coast and who went on to have many hit records around the world. And their first came out called Little Latin Loopy Lou around 1963. And how did you meet them?
We were doing background work for their company at the time, and they needed a girl group. Mm-hmm. To do background, somebody that could, you know, catch on really, really fast, because they never knew what they really wanted, and we had to go in a lot of times and make up the background, and we really got good at that. So they asked us to do it for them.
This was at a time when Bill Medley and Bobby Hatfield were on a label called Moon Glow Records, and this was one of their first that got on the charts, called Little Latin Loopy Lou.
Talk about my baby.
Bill Medley and Bobby Hatfield, and Darlene Love was singing with the Righteous Brothers on a lot of their records, and Darlene was telling me a story behind that tune, Little Latin Loopy Lou. There was such a girl?
A lady that Bill dated in high school. She was a Spanish lady, and she was kind of chubby, and he just wrote about her.
So you can see a lot of these records, there is someone behind the scene. I don't think there was ever a Boney Maroney, though. Or a short, fat Fanny. Who knows, you know?
Yeah, who knows?
I know there was a Peggy Sue, but anyway, we're going to continue on with the Righteous Brothers and one of their greatest recordings that Darlene Love and the Blossoms sang background on, and you will all remember it when we hear it. But first, take heed. The Christmas season has been enriched by a store of traditions from many lands, but whatever the country, whatever the local customs, the basic spirit, the Christmas spirit always remains the same. In Syria, before dawn on Christmas morning, the people gather for Mass in the Syrian church. As the service begins, the priest leans over the altar rail and touches the nearest person with his joined hands. This is known as the touch of peace, and is passed from one person to another until everyone in the congregation has received it. By understanding and sharing the Christmas tradition of others, we share something much deeper, an experience of the heart. For the true message of Christmas is the same in any language, a message of hope, the wish for peace and goodwill among the people and nations of the earth. Oh, so many memories of Christmases. I was just thinking back as some of these records are playing, and we'll kind of reminisce as the week goes on, because you're going to be with us up until Christmas Day. That'll be great to have you here.
Thank you.
You've Lost That Love and Feeling was a unique record at the time. It was produced by Phil Spector, who was also Darlene Love's producer in the 60s. And I imagine when you went in and sang background on this record, it must have been a tremendous experience when everything was finished and you heard it on the playback.
This record was one of those kind of records. I told Phil, how come you can't write something like that for me? Mm. Which was a fantastic record. It's one of those records, when you hear it played back, you go, you just sit there and go, wow. You know, everybody, it's kind of like you're dumbfounded. It turned out so great.
And there were so many musicians that were utilized on this session.
Quite a few.
Had to be very costly.
All of Phil's sessions were costly.
Oh, I heard he used to sometimes go into 2, 3 in the morning.
True. We were dead. Dead tired.
And around this time, you also were appearing on Shindig with the Blossoms.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure you even sang this live on that show, didn't you?
We did, right.
This is the original. The Righteous Brothers, Bill Medley and Bobby Hatfield, and it was a major hit during the Christmas season of 1964. And in the background, Darlene Love and the Blossoms.
You never close your eyes anymore when I kiss your lips. There's no tenderness like before in your fingertips. You're trying hard not to show it, but baby, baby, I know it. You love me, oh, I love me. You lost that love and fear, and now it's gone, gone, gone. Oh, now there's no love.
Don't, don't, don't let
Bill Medley, Bobby Hatfield, along with Darlene Love and the Blossoms on a record that was a hit during the Christmas season of 1964. And this is Jim Pewter reminiscing with Darlene Love. It's a beautiful song, still, you know, is something.
Still today.
Yeah. At that time, the beat of that tune, I imagine a lot of disc jockeys, when they heard it for the first time, thought it might have been a little too slow because it was kind of unique. You know, there was so many tunes that were coming out so fast then.
Right.
And there was a song back in the late 50s, For Your Precious Love, with Jerry Butler, and disc jockeys at the time said, that's a little too slow. But once they played it, people requested it.
Right.
And I just wanted to know, at this time, Phil Spector's company was probably at its zenith then, wasn't it? He was, you know, producing so many hits.
He was it, and it was very unique because he was an independent producer with his own label.
Mm-hmm.
And he was getting a lot of time during those years.
And he was very young at that time.
I don't think Phil was more than 23, 24 at that time.
Mm-hmm. It's amazing when you look back on some of those records. And in fact, all of you were very young.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And yeah. Time moves
babies.
On. We're going to feature a tune here called King of the Surf Guitar by Dick Dale and the Deltones. And Dick Dale was a West Coast phenomena that started the surf rock instrumental sound. And he's been on our show several times. And he was on a label originally called Deltone Records, which sold quite a few records, the first album. And then he went over to Capitol Records, and this was the first Capitol release that that he put out in 1963. It was called King of the Surf Guitar, and Darlene Love and the Blossoms were called in, like you were on so many sessions, to sing background on this. And at the time you saw the music on this, did you kind of feel it was kind of like a Duane Eddy kind of a session? Like,
we did, and we didn't know what we were going to do. We thought we were going to really do oohs and ahs. They gave us some words. And then told us to do, now, what can you do with this? And that's what we came up with. Head sessions.
Uh-huh. They did say, this is what we have in mind, but maybe you can kind of add more to it. Is that kind
That's what happened. That's what started happening after that. They would just give us nothing. They had started just playing the records and say, now, can you make up a background for this?
Here's the Blossoms with Dick Dale. Sound of Dick Dale and the Deltones. Darlene Love is my guest, and she's going to be back tomorrow. We'll be featuring Boss Guitar, He's a Rebel, and some more memories with Bobby Sox and the Blue Jeans. Darlene, I'll see you then, all right?
All right.
You keep it straight ahead. This is Jim Pewter. Bye-bye.